I am Rafa Benitez. You are watching the Redmen TV.
Chris, we got over the line in the end, 3-1 to Liverpool, but some shaky moments at the back.
It was really nervous, especially sort of second half. You know, when it was 1-1, Leicester really got back into the game, didn't they? And you mentioned it during the game. You said it feels like they've got more men than us on the pitch. So when they got a man sent off, it was like it got evened up. Yet they actually performed better for it.
Yeah.
And it was only through counter-attacking and some good forward play that we got into the lead. But it was still nervous, even at 2-1. I was thinking we could quite likely concede it. And that lack of confidence for me just stems from the keeper.
Yeah.
I mean, he's such a flapper. He doesn't inspire anybody in the back line, and you can see the defenders looking around going, what the fuck are we dealing with here? And I know we've just won, and I'm being pretty negative, but this is a problem. I think, you know, if we've just watched Steven Gerrard's interview after the game, and he's talking about making a fight for fourth. I genuinely am worried that we can fight for fourth with him as the keeper.
Yeah.
And that's just how I feel. You know, the win makes me feel good, but the keeper makes me feel fucking shite.
Yeah, there was a point at the start of the second half, and I thought, if we had a world-class striker and a world-class goalkeeper, we'd be a quality team right now. But given that we spent so much money in the summer, maybe the keeper should have been addressed. But on the positives, you know, a 3-1 win, goals from Steven Gerrard as well.
Goal from Steven Gerrard, yeah, a positive. I think I agree with Ryan on his fan reaction, to be honest. I haven't just watched that. I think, for me, Sterling was the man of the match because he did perform for the whole game. Steven Gerrard was influential in the second half. And he grew into the game more when the spaces opened up around him. When it was a little bit tighter and stuff first half, I think he struggled a little bit. The person I'm most pleased with, though, is Raheem Sterling, and not because he was man of the match, but because that was a Raheem Sterling performance, and he's looked so tired and jaded over the last few games that I've just not seen that from him. And he looked like he was finally willing to go on and attack his man and just cause problems for that team, and that's not something that I've seen recently, so I'm absolutely made up to see the real Raheem Sterling stand up.
Oh.
Put it back in the box, come on, back in the box.
Sure's kiss me.
Just selecting his club.
Fuck off.
Told you we can't fucking